Busan is a vibrant city filled with rich culture, beautiful scenery, and endless places to explore. But traveling here on your own can get a little tricky. So, to help you better navigate this breathtaking city, we've put together a series of videos that'll take you through all the different parts of Busan in easy-to-follow daily itineraries. So if you'd like to ride the waves at Busan's most famous surfing beach, feel the culture at Korea's most beautiful temple, and shop at one of Busan's largest outlet malls, then join us today. Our trip starts at Songjeong Beach. From Haeundae, it'll take you around 14 minutes to get there, and the cab ride will cost around 6,500 won, which is about $6 American. So this is Songjeong Beach. It's Busan's single most famous beach for surfing, and it's open all year round. In fact, it's the middle of December right now, and there's still people here surfing. Let's go check it out. In Busan, there are three main beaches that pretty much everyone goes to: Haeundae, Gwangalli, and this one, Songjeong Beach. Of the three beaches, this one's the smallest, and generally, it gets the least crowded. So, if you're looking to find a beach with a more chill vibe, then this is the one for you. Another cool thing you can do here is you can rent a surfboard and even take surfing lessons. The waves over here are a little bit stronger, but if you can't swim, don't worry. The water is still shallow and the sand is nice and soft. On the other side, you'll find cute cafes, restaurants, and hotels lining the beach. Because this beach is smaller than the other two beaches, the nightlife here doesn't compare, but you'll still find a few delicious places to dine at. One place I always visit here is Moon Toast Cafe. They started off as a simple food truck, and back then, you'd have to wait in such a long lineup just to get a sandwich. Now, they've opened up their own restaurant, so let's go check them out. So I really wanted to be able to show you all Moon Toast Cafe, but unfortunately on Tuesdays they're closed. But if you ever do come to Songjeong Beach, I highly recommend checking out this place. So since that didn't work out, we decided to give this other place a shot that we haven't tried yet. One thing we heard about this place is that on the second floor, they have a rooftop patio with amazing views of the beach. Pogo sticks over here in Korea are like super popular. You see pogo stick or hot dog places almost everywhere. Kind of strange. When you think about Korea, you don't think about pogo sticks or hot dogs, but they're good. They're really good. Let's try it out. Mmm. 완전 맛있어. And right after, we went to go grab a few coffees before leaving the beach. Chagia, 누구도 잘 생겼어? And that's it for the beach today. Maybe next time, we'll show you what it's like here during the summer. I know you're gonna love it. But now, we're off to our next destination, Korea's most beautiful temple, Haedong Yonggungsa. From here, it'll be around a 10-minute cab ride, and that'll cost you around $5. Before arriving at the temple, you'll first pass by a bunch of different vendors selling trinkets, souvenirs, drinks, and different Korean street food, like fish cake and rice cake. But don't spoil your appetite here. We'll be heading to lunch right after this. After making it past the front gates, you'll immediately see statues of the zodiac characters to your left, as well as a few other Buddhist statues and shrines to your right. And at the very end of the row, you'll see a massive 8-story pagoda made with intricate Buddhist designs. You probably didn't notice it, but at its base, there's actually a shrine with a car tire. I heard that people will often say a prayer here to help them avoid getting into car accidents. Now the entrance to the temple actually starts right here, by this stunning gate with these two dragons. When this temple was first built, the head monk at the time had a dream that the Buddhist goddess of mercy was riding a dragon, and henceforth, this temple became known as the Dragon's Palace Temple. And as we head towards the temple, we're going to go down 108 stairs. Now, these stairs are meant to signify the 108 delusions of the mind in Buddhism. And check out these lanterns. It's honestly so beautiful just walking through here. So whether you're Buddhist or not, you'll still find this place both scenic and impressive. So they say that if you throw a coin in here, you can make a wish. And I'm wishing that you hit that like button. So normally, you would find temples inside of mountains. But what makes this temple so beautiful is the fact that it's settled right in front of the sea. The view from here is breathtaking. After passing the bridge, you'll enter the center of the temple, where you'll find the main building. And here, you'll often see monks praying. The architecture of the buildings are beautifully made with vibrant colors. You can't help but feel Korea's rich culture and heritage. Now, this temple was originally built in the 14th century. However, shortly after it was built, during one of the Japanese occupations, they burnt down and destroyed the temple. This temple was then later rebuilt in 1930, and since then, it's become one of Busan's top attractions. So now we're getting pretty hungry, so our next stop is going to be at Buak Udonjip. From the temple, it'll take around 5 minutes to get there, and the cab ride will cost around $4. Now this restaurant gets pretty busy. As you're about to see, you'll usually have to wait in line. So when you first arrive, sign up at the front desk and get your number in line. The menu here is super simple, and basically everyone orders the same thing, the udon special. They do have other items, such as pork cutlet and cold soba noodle, but I'd strongly recommend just getting the regular udon special. It tastes amazing, and it comes with so much. For under 11,000 won, which is around $10 American, you'll get the udon soup with shredded kelp and mushrooms, as well as all these other sides. There's something about this udon that we absolutely love. We personally come here all the time for lunch, because you get a little bit of everything. From the udon soup to crispy tempura, you get their special kimbap and their delicious fried kimchi. This place never disappoints, and you'll leave here feeling happy and full. Next up, we're heading to Lotte Premium Outlet Mall to burn off some of those calories. From here, it'll be around a 3-minute cab ride that'll cost you around $4. But instead of taking a cab, if it's a nice day outside, you can simply walk over. Now this time, I'll let you join us for a quick car ride over to the mall. By the way, driving over here in Korea actually just feels like driving back in Canada or America. Despite Korea having densely populated areas, here in Busan, I actually find it quite comfortable driving here. So you can see how close it is from the Udon restaurant to Lotte Premium Outlet Mall. It's about like a 5-minute walk, but you can also take a cab and it'll cost you like $3. Lotte Premium Outlet Mall contains a wide variety of high-end designer brands to reasonably priced local Korean brands. So this mall offers something for every type of shopper. This mall is also divided into two parts, the outlet section and the mall section. The outlet area feels like it's kind of outdoors because there's no roof overhead, but the mall section is completely indoors. The selection of the stores are also completely divided. Inside the mall, you'll find mostly Korean brands. And honestly, you'll have so much fun browsing through these stores. Because here, you'll probably find some amazing deals from brands that you've probably never heard of. But don't let that fool you. Korea is such a fashion-forward, trend-setting nation. The people here really know how to dress well. And because of that, you just might be able to find your next favorite outfit at a price that you're actually happy to pay. One of my personal favorite things about shopping is being able to find good deals. And here, you might actually have a chance to. The outlet section contains all the designer brands that you've probably already heard of. From high-end designer brands, all the way down to casual, and over to sports apparel. So if you're ever in need of some retail therapy, then come check out this mall. You won't be disappointed. So that wraps up our first tour of Busan. From here, it'll take you around 20 minutes to get back to Haeundae, and your cab ride will cost you around 8,600 won, which is around $8. So I hope you enjoyed our first ever episode in this series that explores all the best places there is to visit here in Busan. If you enjoyed the video, please remember to like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time somewhere in Korea.